Hey there, I'm Jess Altieri, and welcome to Wine Channel TV for our Sonomalicious special, where I'm going to show you how to wine, dine, and have a great time on any budget. Soups, and we're going to share with you our kindergarten wine pairing lesson to show you how you can have a big time on a small budget. So I'm here at the beautiful Sunflower Cafe with Aaron. Aaron, great to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
And we're having a blast. When I walked in, it was packed. Tell me about this restaurant. From what you told me, it's always jam-packed in here.
Yeah, we've become a pretty popular local hangout. We're one of the more casual places around the square, but we also do a really good job of having nice, simple, sophisticated food without being too pretentious or anything like that. You kind of run into that in the wine country sometimes, so we try to be the cool spot and not be... Not
stuffy, not pretentious.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what I like. Tell me what you guys are known for here. What type of cuisine?
It's actually kind of hard to put your finger on it because our chef has a lot of international inspiration.
Yeah.
The thing that we featured on the Food Network was our lamb burger.
Ooh, yum.
It is really awesome. People come in here all the time asking for it now. Unfortunately, it's seasonal.
Right.
But spring through summer, we have that going every day. We also do our signature sandwich is a duck breast sandwich.
Right.
Smoked duck breast. Melted Gruyere, some organic greens. I think we'll try that today at some point.
I can't
wait. With a glass of red wine.
That brings me to my next point. So today we're talking about the perfect, I call them kindergarten wine and food pairings. Mm-hmm. So you don't have to be a rocket scientist or a sommelier to find out the perfect pairings or have a great budget. So what would be great with, we're having a fantastic Pinot Noir right here. Mm-hmm. You mentioned like the lamb burger when it's in season or something else, the duck breast sandwich,
yeah,
I think?
Yeah, the duck breast, I mean, both of those would go great with red wine.
And it's pretty affordable here, right?
We like to give something to everybody. We don't want anybody to have to come in here in a suit, have everybody come out, drink wine, order wine from the snobby ass wine club.
Ha! I saw the sign behind us. That kicks ass.
Yeah,
right. Well, awesome. Thanks, man.
Thank you.
I'm looking forward to trying all those tasty dishes. And that'll be coming up next on our Red Teeth Rocks segment. You won't want to miss it. So I'm here with James. Cheers.
Cheers.
At the wonderful Sunflower Cafe. And tell me first about the wine that we're drinking because it is so Sonomalicious. That's what I like to say.
Excellent. Well, actually, the grapes are from Anderson Valley, an area where I grew up and we farmed back in 1972.
Okay.
And I still have a relationship with my friend from back in the day when we were 6 years old, and he farms over 500 acres up there.
Wow.
Norman Coburn. We decided to come full circle for the family and make wine. And so this is my wife's last name, her family last name.
Oh, okay.
My last name was taken, so we...
How do you pronounce that?
Chaname.
Chaname,
yeah,
okay.
Chaname. And we wanted to go with a very, a wine that's very expressive of the place. I think it's pretty common.
So today we're talking about why Red Teeth Rock. I think it's a very food-friendly wine. And that takes us to all these delicious dishes that we have going on here. First, I'm sure everyone wants to know what we have here, because these are all items at the Sunflower Cafe, starting with it's the duck breast sandwich.
Sure, so the duck
get out of
town.
Yeah. And you have to tell the story behind this, because I can't order it any way I want.
Exactly, you can't. It's the one item that Chef Curtis, who's been cooking in the Valley for 40 years, he said, please give me one item that I can have complete reign over. And so on our menu it says, no variations, don't ask. But there's a good reason for that, and that is because the way that we put it together with the toasted and baguettes and the melted cheese, the Gruyere cheese, the smoked duck breast, it's just the perfect combination of flavors and textures. And so, really, we don't allow any variations. We don't mean to be snotty about it, but it just needs to be served perfectly.
So I won't mess with that. I think that would be a perfect pairing with your Pinot Noir, the nice smokiness to it. It would bring out the nice flavors. Anyways, I can't wait to try that. But tell me about what else we have here.
And in here, we actually released this dish, or first introduced it to the market, back at the Charles Schwab tournament that they did here about four years ago now.
Okay.
And it really took best of show, and so it's a goat cheese stuffed piquillo pepper. It's La Rochelle Chèvre.
Oh.
And we have honey and orange zest, a little bit of pistachio nuts in there.
Yum, nice crunch.
Served in this beautiful little boat that we had custom made for us, and with some nice toasted baguettes. Beautiful.
That's gorgeous.
Good with a crisp white wine, like a Riesling.
That's what we were saying, a nice little Riesling from here. Yeah, that'd be perfect. And how about the nice, beautiful platter? This is the next one going on here.
Paying homage to the original founders of this area, we have a Spanish platter. So we have an 18-month-aged Serrano ham imported. We have a beautiful Spanish chorizo and a blood sausage here, and a manchego cheese with membrillo paste. Just a great assortment of flavors and textures here as well. Probably for this plate, I would pair it with a Spanish garnacha.
Yes.
Which is actually our current house wine.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's beautiful.
Tell me about your wine selection here.
Sure.
Is it varied or great price range?
Well, based on where we are, of course, we always want to primarily pay homage to the local winemakers that do such a great job. And that specifically represent the varietal classification well.
Uh-huh.
So if it's a Sauv Blanc, if it's a Char, we really want it to be a great representation of Chardonnay.
Got it.
Or Sauvignon Blanc. But we aren't afraid to embrace our cousins to the north over in
Napa.
We have a beautiful Tempranillo and Cab from there, of course. We do have, I just said, a Spanish Garnacha, a French Champagne. It's good to have comparisons.
Yep.
I think in each category that represent the category well.
Mm, give me a little cheers. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. And next time coming up, we're going to be talking about the perfect happy hour spot in Sonoma, which is right here. You won't want to miss it. Cheers. Happy hour, my favorite time of day, and I'm joined by John. Cheers.
Yes. Cheers, Jess.
The resident happy hour expert. That's what I'm calling you from now on.
I'll take it.
And Yelp community manager, right?
Yes,
so indeed. Tell me about that. What does that mean?
As a Yelp community manager, we connect people with great local businesses.
Oh.
Here in the Bay Area, especially in Sonoma, like Sunflower Cafe.
So it's your job to just go scout out amazing spots. What a fun job.
It's a good job, yeah. The best part about the job, really, is working with passionate business owners.
Yeah, okay.
I mean, like James here at Sunflower Cafe, learning about how he's been in the wine industry for 40 years, making his own wine that we can drink here today.
Enjoys fabulous Pinot Noir.
Exactly.
So we're talking about happy hour. What makes this a great happy hour spot in your mind?
Well, my favorite thing about their happy hour here is that it's happy hour. It's
happy
from
hour.
3 to 4.
Oh.
Exactly. So get in at 3. You have 1 hour to drink their $5 glasses of wine, including the Chamonix Pinot Noir.
Happy afternoon into night. Yeah. I like that. 3 o'clock. What a great start.
And it's one of those local places where a lot of people, winemakers, will hang out.
Oh, is
here.
It?
Yeah, exactly. And it's dog friendly, so you can show up with your pooch, hang out on the back patio. Here.
I wish I lived here. I could bring my big fat golden retriever Boomer with.
Yes.
He would love it.
Yes.
Exactly. And so the last thing I want to ask you is on Yelp, can you actually type in happy hour spots?
Yeah. When you're traveling to Sonoma or anywhere around the country and 19 other countries around the world, you can type in happy hour, and a place like Sunflower will come right up.
That's so easy. Yeah, and then you can see all the ratings and the pictures of everything going on.
Exactly.
Easy
enough.
And you
can find out that it's from 3 to 4 or dog friendly, et cetera. Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah,
so wait, one last question.
Yeah.
If you had a pick to have a perfect happy hour pairing, what would it be?
I'd go with Pinot and blood sausage with my pooch on a patio.
All right, get that blood sausage. I know you've been dying to have some. I'll toast my glass of wine to your blood sausage. Cheers. Coming up next, we're talking about wine and social media and why they go hand in hand. Hey there. Now we're talking about wine and social media with the beautiful Abby. Great to see you. Cheers. And so first, tell everyone about what you do. I know you work for Yelp.
I do. I'm a community manager here in the Bay Area, and one of my many jobs is to spread the Yelpy love amongst all the
Yelpy love. Oh, I like that.
Very warm fuzzies. We're definitely about the warm fuzzies at Yelp, and getting the community together on and offline to share their experiences with great local businesses.
So you really are a social media expert. I mean, you know everything that's going on. And so people coming, so I'm a tourist. I'm visiting from Chicago out here to beautiful Sonoma. What would I type in to find the perfect wine spots in Yelp?
The great thing about Yelp is you could do a search for just about anything, especially in the Bay Area. Yelp is headquartered here. We're the motherland.
The motherland.
So you really could find anything you want to type of specific wine if you're looking for a wine bar or a tasting room.
Oh, nice. And the part that you mentioned to me before when we were chatting is that it's non-pretentious, like, reviews. So you could find anything, and it's all about sharing, like you said. You don't have to be an expert. To write anything.
So anyone can read and write reviews on Yelp. It's absolutely free to do so. So whether you're searching for a great winery to visit or a wine bar, or whether you want to share your experience of a wonderful time you had in Napa or Sonoma.
Like here at the Sunflower Cafe. And then my last question for you is, if you could have one last glass of wine, what would it be and who would you share it with?
I would love to have a sparkling Malbec.
Great pick.
A girlfriend and I were at a really great wine bar and oyster spot in L.A. We tried a sparkling Malbec, which is very rare, with oysters.
Ooh.
Wonderful time with girlfriends. I recommend it to anyone that loves red wine and sparkling.
Sign me up for that.
Cheers to
that. I'm going to meet you the next time I'm here in town, and we're going to go just to L.A. to get that.
Sounds like a plan.
And since we're talking about social media, to find out more information about everything Wine Channel TV related, make sure to visit facebook.com/winetv. Coming up next is our segment on Wine of the Week. You won't want to miss it. Cheers. If you're in Sonoma and craving amazing thin crust pizza, salads, and vino, well, look no further than the Red Grape. Follow me as we head on inside and show you our wine of the week and the perfect food pairings. Hey there, so I'm joined by the lovely Nikki, or Dominique. It depends, I guess, on the day. And we're here at the Red Grape, and cheers. We're talking about our wine of the week. And we got a little bubbly to start out, a little sparkling wine from Gloria Farrar. And I know you're a big bubbly, sparkling champagne fan, even though this is not champagne.
Yes, we can call it bubbly, that's about it. But yeah, if I had to drink any wine for the rest of my life, it would be something with bubbles.
Really?
I think it's because my mom introduced me to Moscato very early on.
Oh, that's what I call heaven in a glass. So first, tell everyone about yourself and what you do with Yelp.
Yeah, so I am a community manager for Yelp in the East Bay. So everything east of San Francisco. And my job is to kind of just keep people excited about Yelp and help them discover all the cool things they can do on the site, off the site. So we like to plan events that bring Yelpers off the site to meet each other in person.
What a fun job.
It's fun.
No, I have to admit that. And you said you were one of the top Yelpers, right, before that, or you did the most reviews and everything.
I was definitely a Yelp fanatic.
That's awesome. Yes. It's your passion.
Yeah, well, we have a name for Yelp fanatics, and it's Yelp Elite Squad.
Yelp Elite Squad.
Right, so if you like to be a VIP, you can do that on Yelp. The most active reviewers on the site, the ones who contribute the most, they get invited to be part of this elite squad.
Does it have to be positive comments that they give usually, or it's just being honest?
We want a little bit of everything, but of course it's nice to share what you love about a place most of the time, and then occasionally you have the not so nice experience.
So how would you rate this place? I mean, you look at everything, right? The food, the atmosphere, a little bit of all?
Yeah, and I think that's what's great about Yelp is it's everyone's personal opinion about how the overall experience is. So food is obviously very important. I think wine for me is important too, or cocktails. And then ambiance, service, kind of just the overall feeling.
I like that. And you mentioned that you have some exciting kind of new things coming up with Yelp.
There's always new things.
New tools.
We're always developing the site, and especially now that everyone's using their smartphones, we're just about everything you would do on your computer, we're now doing on our phones. So the Yelp app is constantly evolving to kind of meet those needs and to make sure everything you want to find is on your phone through the Yelp app. So when you're out and about, and say you have this amazing tower of truffle, fried sage, onion rings.
By the way, perfect pairing with a sparkling wine. I always say one of my favorite pairings, fried chicken and sparkling wine or champagne. It just goes well. The acidity of the sparkling wine cuts through the fattiness of the greasy food, fried food. Heaven.
Exactly.
Yes.
So obviously you want to show off to your friends that you're having this amazing lunch.
Uh-huh.
So you take a picture, upload it to the Red Grape's Yelp page.
Right.
And add a little note, definitely order this while you're here with a glass of Gloria Ferrer and
easy peasy. And you mentioned, wait, did you say you can also make reservations through Open Table?
You can. Any restaurant that has Open Table as an option for reservations is now integrated through the Yelp app. So as you're looking at pictures and checking out if you want to go to this restaurant, if you decide you do, you can go ahead and make that reservation through Yelp.
Huh. I like that. Easy enough. Well, cheers to you and to our big onion ring stack, which we have to dive into. And coming up next, we're talking about our Taste of the Month pairing with some fantastic pizzas and wine here at the Red Grape that you won't want to miss. Fantastic Red Grape, talking about our Taste of the Month pairings, and I'm joined by Chef Todd. Great to see you, Chef.
Yeah, good to see you too.
Let's do a little toast. And talk to us about the Red Grape. I know you're known for your pizza, but many other things.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, one of the reasons that our community loves us is for our thin crust pizza. It's very similar to a couple types of pizzas that you might find in Connecticut.
Isn't that where the owners were from? I saw that originally. Yeah, I read that somewhere online.
Went out to the East Coast for a short period of time and stumbled upon this kind of pizza and brought it back to Sonoma.
I was going to say, so I lived in New York for a while. My family's all from New York, New Jersey, and it reminds me of the good thin crust slices of pizza you get there.
Exactly.
It's hard to find.
We also do a number of sandwiches, paninis, and a variety of really great pastas. So,
and pastas like this. What do we got going on here?
Well, this actually is an appetizer. This is our sausage and mussels.
That's a meal. That's an appetizer?
Yeah, absolutely. Just a little appetizer. Fantastic to split or to come in and have for a lunch.
Yeah, sign me up for that.
Yeah,
and then tell me about the other two delicious pizzas we got going on.
Okay, so this one right here is our pesto chicken.
Yum.
It's pesto base with grilled chicken, tomatoes, and pine nuts.
Nice.
Really simple, but the flavors just pop on that one. And this one right here is actually our tray fungi, which...
fresh garlic? Sorry, I'm stealing a piece right now.
Yeah, comes with little garlic chips on top. We have a variety of artisanal wild mushrooms that change from season to season. And fontina cheese, a little fried rosemary. Perfect pizza.
Perfection. Perfecto.
Perfect.
And so we're talking about our perfect Taste of the Month pairing. So I thought something with, you said the mushrooms, and then the hearty, you said sausage in here with the mussels.
Yeah, absolutely.
You need a big, bold red wine. So tell me about the red wine that we have here, the Three Fat Guys.
Okay.
Love the name.
Yeah, I do too. So the story behind this wine is Jason Spitz, Darren College, and Tony Moll, who are all ex-Packers.
Okay.
And relatives of the owner. Actually, a son-in-law is Tony Moll, opened this label, the Three Fat Guys. And when you're looking for one really big, bold red, this
it's a big,
is absolutely
fat
the way to
red
go.
Wine. But it has a perfect smooth finish. It has the nice, almost blackberry, earthy mushroom notes in there. It's not too overpowering, really well-balanced. That would make it a perfect pairing, even with a light pizza like that, but even better with something heartier like the sausage.
Exactly.
There. Done and done. I love
done
that.
Done and done. You asked me earlier about some wines that I find very near and dear to my heart.
Yes.
One of the things about being a chef and being actually in the Napa Valley is we like to drink our wine right away. So there's not a lot in my storage. The one thing that I do have that was a gift from Jude Wilmoth at Cook in St. Helena is a 1996 Grace Family Vineyards Cabernet.
Wow.
And it's something that I got to try about 5 or 6 years ago, and it goes really, really great with a steak and a day off.
Oh.
So,
done.
Yeah, it's just fantastic. So that's,
enough
that's one of those
said.
Things that
that a steak and a day off. I think that is the perfect pairing.
Exactly.
Well, thanks, Chef. I appreciate that.
Thank you.
Looking
Cheers.
Forward to eating some more great food. Coming up next, we're going to be talking with some Yelp experts on what's hot in 2013. Talking about what's hot in 2013 for Yelpers.
Sure.
And I told you my problem. I admit it. I just go on there and look at the pictures.
That's not a problem. That's a
good admit
problem.
My faults. What else should I be looking for?
A lot of times, you know, the best thing that Yelpers are searching for are authenticity from business owners.
Oh,
right?
I like that. Yeah.
Yeah. You know, business owners are really passionate about their business, and that really translates into what Yelpers are writing on Yelp.
How can you tell that it's, authentic? You mean by the way that they go on and share certain things?
Yeah, you know,
or
like
it's experiences?
When we go to a little cafe and the owner is making his own wine, right?
Oh,
and he's
yeah.
there to tell you about that. That's a perfect example.
I like that. What a great point.
Yeah.
And you personally, what do you go on and look for when you go on Yelp? I'm curious.
I would say, ambiance is a huge thing. Lighting.
Really?
I'm very sensitive to light.
Lighting?
Yeah.
Huh. So do you like go on and
keep the lights low?
Bright lighting?
I do.
Oh, you want it low? Or
yeah,
what?
Yeah. Keep it, like a dimly lit dive bar, right?
Oh, so you can bring in all your little dates and,
when I go in alone, hang on.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
And I need to know, though, so we're sipping some great Napa Valley Cabernet.
Are we?
If you could have one last glass of wine with anyone, who would it be and why? I want to really get to know you.
Okay. Who would it be? So are you looking for a celebrity?
They could be alive, dead, anybody. You could say your dog.
I would say my girlfriend.
I hope she's watching. So cute. We got some shaking heads over here. Yeah. Going, no. But cheers to that.
Cheers. Yeah.
And your happy girlfriend. Oh. Coming up next, we get some of our fans' favorite wine and hand stories. Won't want to miss this. So now I'm joined by the beautiful Nikki again and from Yelp, and we're talking about our favorite wine in hand stories. Only ones that we can say, actually. No
right.
naughty ones.
Not the ones I wouldn't want my grandma to hear.
So you mentioned you had a good one.
I do have some good ones. I think one that is kind of ongoing is that every time we have friends over for a dinner party, we'll always offer them some baby maker after dinner.
Baby maker?
And they're always like,
okay, what's baby maker?
I want that, but you definitely do want it. If someone offers you baby maker, take it. The baby's not guaranteed, but it's wine that is like so delicious that you would drink the whole bottle by yourself, no problem, and then whoops, maybe there's a baby that comes from it.
I love this.
Yeah, so that's a
baby. Do you hear this? That's the new lingo to remember. Baby maker wine.
Yeah, it's always a crowd pleaser. And those are just typically dessert wines.
Yeah.
And then my other story is staying at a hostel in Nice, France.
I love Nice. One of the most beautiful places.
Oh. Yeah. So I was desperate to stay there, and the only hostel was like this former monastery. So it was beautiful, it was cheap, but it was very strict. So they had a curfew. You couldn't leave the grounds after 10 p.m. or something like that. So a group of us obviously wanted to go out drinking, and we hopped over the gate, snuck out. The only thing nearby was like a little mini mart. So in France, you can get good, cheap wine for like $3. So we get, wine in a box, orange juice in a box, some fruit, and we made this like, makeshift sangria.
Killer sangria, it sounds like.
And snuck it back to the hostel, and as we're coming over the fence with all our goods, we got caught.
No.
And so we had to give it all up, but...
You had to give it all up? To who? At the monastery?
Yeah.
They drink?
I'm sure they drank
a lot.
Oh. Yeah.
Thanks so much, girl.
Yeah. Cheers.
Cheers to us and your fantastic wine and hand stories.
And sangria.
And sangria. And coming up next, you won't want to miss it, we're going to talk about wine cribs. Yes, wine cribs. Where do people store their wine and what's inside of their wine cribs? When in Sonoma, if you're looking for the ultimate Italian wine crib, well, look no further than Della Santina's Trattoria and their Enoteca next door. They have the perfect wine pairing for any occasion. Follow me. Cheers. We're here at, and pronounce it correctly for me, Della Santina's Trattoria.
Trattoria.
I always say that. And we're at the Enoteca, though, next door. And so we have some amazing food. We're talking about the perfect food and wine pairings, Italian style, here in Sonoma. First, tell us about the restaurant, in case people haven't been here.
Well, the restaurant was founded by my dad, Quirico, in 1990. So I joined him in 91. And just kind of brought a little bit of wine knowledge to the restaurant, and opened the Enoteca here 6 years ago. So this is a relatively new adventure. So
So are you a wine snob? Come on, be honest. I walked in here, I go, oh my gosh, no. I was saying before, the ultimate wine crib. You got the stones on the wall, all the wines lined up. I love it, I'm at home.
The wine is good, if I always tell people, if you like it, it's good. If
this
you don't like it, it's not your wine. So you don't have to be a snob about it at all. It's just, we in Italy, wine is considered food. We pair it with what we eat, so that's the most important thing. So.
But how many wines do you have in here? I don't even ask you.
We have several hundred.
Wow.
So between the restaurant and the bar, there is quite a few, yeah.
Perfect. And tell me about, I'm dying to know, the delicious dishes over here.
Some of our dishes that we've done over the past 23 years. This is my grandmother's gnocchi. We call it gnocchi della nonna.
Ah.
Real fresh tomato, basil sauce, very simple. This gnocchi recipe, my dad has carried over. This is from Tuscany, from Lucca. Yeah, this dish, we like to pair with a little langhe nebbiolo. So this is Laura and Enrica Facendo. They're from Piemonte. We recently did a dinner with this couple in beautiful property in Barolo, about 25 acres, and just a really soft, elegant wine. Great with food, nice acid.
Perfect pairing with the gnocchi.
Yeah.
And then how about the next one?
On the far right, we have a little pish espada, so with risotto, so a little swordfish.
That's one of my favorites.
Yeah, we just grill it, a little roasted garlic, rosemary over the top. The risotto has a little bit of spinach and tomato in it, a little white wine reduction. That dish, my dad prefers to always feature the fish, and never oversauce the fish, so that's what we do here. We're pairing it with my own label, the house label, which is the R. Sellers. So that's the Chardonnay, all from Jay Vineyard up in Russian River, 2009.
How long have you been doing that?
The label we started it's been about 3 years now. So
congratulations.
Yeah, so it's great. So we do a little
cheers to that.
Thank you very much. Little Chardonnay, Pinot Noir, and Rosé.
And tell me about this last one.
Last
looks like Fred Flintstone's dish. Look how big that is.
The last dish is one of my personal favorites. It's a braised California lamb shank. We braise it with root vegetables. And in Tuscany, we're... The nickname for Tuscans that I mentioned before, people from the south like to call us polentani.
I love polenta, even though I'm Sicilian.
Because we actually like to eat polenta. So this one I paired with a very special bottle from Fontari. This is one of their reserve Chiantis, and Giovanni Manetti is the winemaker. He's done several events with us. He's one of the top winemakers in Italy, so fantastic wine.
Perfect pairings. Cool. I can't wait to dive in. And I got to know, do you have any special events coming up that people should know about?
We'll be doing a chocolate and wine pairing in the bar just before Valentine's Day on the 8th of February.
Right up my alley.
There you go.
You don't have to twist my arm.
So we're going to do some local reds with chocolate. So it'll be infused in the chocolate. So it'll be kind of cool.
Even better.
Yep.
And so my last fun question,
yes.
I didn't tell you about this. If you could have one last glass of wine with anyone, who would it be and why?
That's a great question. I would say probably, who would I have a glass of wine with? I would probably really like to have a glass of wine with my grandmother, I'd say.
Oh.
So, and probably she liked to drink light white, so maybe a little Pinot Grigio or something with my grandmother. Perfect.
Salute to that.
Yep.
Cheers. Can't wait to dive in. Coming up next, we talk to our fans out here at Della Fontina's about some of their questions that they have for me. Ask those stuff. I don't want to ask them. So I'm here, John.
Yes,
great to see you again from Yelp.
Yes.
And so I know you had a question for me. This is our Ask Just segment.
So yeah, question. I'm a huge beer drinker, but and I know how to pair a beer with a dish, but I don't know how to pair wine with food. So walk me through what you look for when you're pairing with your Italian restaurant.
Great question.
Here tonight.
Right.
Yeah.
I always have one rule of thumb, a very simple rule to remember if you're at somewhere like this. It's easy. Think about the regionality, like where you're at. So if you're Italian, think Italian. Look for Italian wines, obviously, first of all. If you're at a Spanish tapas place, think about a great Spanish wine to go with your dish.
Sure.
That's what I always say, the easiest way to go. But other than that, there are no really set rules, per se. There, some people say only white with white, red with red.
Mm-hmm.
No, I say you drink what you like. drink what makes you happy at the end of the day.
That's a good rule.
And then, so speaking of, though, regionality, I'm throwing a question back at you.
Here we are.
So if I just wanted to type in, if I was in the mood for, like, Spanish food and I went on Yelp, I just type in, like, Spanish whatever, and then it'll come right up.
Of course, especially tapas. Yeah, and when you're in the Bay Area, you can look up anything specific. And let's say you have a polenta allergy, like I know you do.
Yeah.
So you need to, if you type in polenta allergy.
Really? Polenta allergy?
Well, I don't know who went out there.
But but that's a good point. Yeah. So I could type in vegan or lactose free or something like that.
Yeah. Huh. Absolutely. Yeah.
I love technology nowadays.
Yes.
That's fantastic. Well, cheers to that.
Hey, cheers to you.
And to our, and your pink wine.
Yes.
Real men drink pink. Cheers to that. Coming up next, tell you about the perfect place to find a nightcap here in Sonoma and tell you what to do in your glass. So we're here talking about the perfect nightcap and what should be in your glass, and I'm joined by the beautiful Nikki. Great to see you.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Good to see you.
And we have our sexy little glasses. Mm-hmm. Tell me, so if I'm searching on Yelp, you work for Yelp, what makes a great nightcap spot?
Well, I think when it comes to nightcaps and kind of getting in the sultry mood, you definitely want some low lighting.
Like we have here.
We have some good low lighting here. And I mean, there's so many places that run the gamut between kind of dive bar status and fancy classy wine bar. So whatever you're in the mood for, you can type that exact feeling.
Really?
Yep. So if I put in low lighting, I guarantee you'll have plenty of places that show up where people have written great low lighting at this place. So that's always something to look for.
How about if I type in like sexy music, something?
Sexy music. Like that. I mean, I love to review music at restaurants. So
yeah.
If they have, you know, a DJ spinning old school records, that might be something you stumble upon in the reviews. Another thing you can search for is specific liqueurs or alcohol that's kind of your nightcap of choice.
So if I put in, for example, we're drinking Late Harvest Riesling, which is perfect, nice and sweet, great way to end the night, and it looks pretty. Come on.
It does.
Could I put that right in and say Late Harvest Riesling or dessert wines that
I'm
looking for?
You could type in whatever your liquor of choice is. Maybe you want an Irish coffee. Any of those buzzwords will come up in the Yelp reviews and in the search.
And I could put in the specific area. So right now, we're at Della Santina's, the Enoteca next door, but I can put in my little zip code and see if there's another cute wine bar right next door or something.
Show the map listing, get directions, make reservations, all that good stuff.
Easy enough. Yeah. And so I said, I love this, but I need to know for you, if you could be, my fun question, a wine varietal, what would you be and why? Are you something bubbly or are you a zesty Malbec?
Yeah, I would probably have to be something bubbly just because that is what I want to drink all the time.
Right.
So yeah, anything with a little fizz to it, Prosecco, Cava, Champagne.
Hey, cheers to what makes you happy. Cheers. I love that. And coming up next, we're with the fan to find out another great wine and dance story. Joined by the one and only Abby from Yelp. Great to see you again. Cheers. Ching ching. And I know you have a great story.
So I know that one of the things that you love about wine is not being pretentious or snooty.
Yeah.
And I think that one of the best ways to try wine and really sample it and enjoy it with people that you're with, rather than worrying about scores or tasting notes you may or may not recognize, like the soil or the ground.
Yeah.
I liken my wine tastings to relationships, specifically dating.
Oh.
So when I'm sampling a wine, I might sniff, do the three S's, sniff, sip, and swirl.
Yes, you know.
And say, oh, well, that one looked good on paper, but maybe it wasn't the best one for me. Or, oh, I would take that wine home and do some really dirty things to it. Or, oh, maybe
we learned earlier today, that's the baby maker wine.
Baby maker, this one's going to make me some babies tonight. Or I'd love to marry this wine. Or I would go out with this wine a few times, maybe or maybe not call him back.
Right.
So it's a fun way to get involved with wine without being too terribly serious about it. And the best thing is when you're done and you realize what you like, you can take notes on the Yelp app.
Oh.
Bookmark it, come back, and share those relationship stories with other people.
So I can write there, this is a one-night stand wine.
You definitely could definitely make some notebook market and come back.
Easy enough. Wow, that's so fun. So interesting. I never would have thought of that.
Love and wine, they go together.
And okay, love and wine go together. So I need to know, what type of wine do you love? So I've asked someone before this, if you were a wine, what would you be and why?
I would like to be a GSM, which California blends are really hot right now, but it's a great, you know, tradition. Like a GSM is what? Grenache,
Syrah, Mourvèdre.
Yes.
Yeah.
I like a little all three, and it's a little bit interesting, but still.
You got the
solid.
Layers to you, a little bit of complexity. Cheers to that, to being complex.
Thank you.
Cheers, and for more information, make sure to visit facebook.com/winechannelTV. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned to Wine Channel TV for more wine happenings around the world. Until then, I'm Jess Dust, reminding you that wine is just a conversation waiting to happen. Cheers!